The Philippine Stock Exchange sees another sell-off on Tuesday on lingering monetary policy and currency concerns. The details in this report.
Most Asian markets faltered on Tuesday, mainly on monetary and economic developments across the globe. Today, there's retail sales and producer prices in Australia and Japan, respectively, while in Shanghai, new measures to shore up the Chinese financial hub's housing sector. Investors also kept a close watch on comments by European Central Bank officials hinting of rate cuts in the world's largest economic bloc. Here at home, Philippine shares dropped by 1%, sliding almost to the 6,400 level. AB Securities' Alfred Garcia points to still uncertain prospects of rate cuts and peso weakening for what he calls a make or break for the local market.
I think the market is still continually pricing the changing scenarios when it comes to rate cuts. We're not getting a clear direction yet, so that's why we're getting these wild swings recently. And also the peso has been, well, the dollar has been strengthening against the peso, whichever way you look at it. So this also affects the outlook for Philippine companies.
In corporate stories, PLDT and its employees union agreed to start talks for a new collective bargaining agreement. The telco giant says it would begin negotiations with the union at a still unidentified date ahead of the CBA's expiration this November. The move averts a planned strike by PLDT employees, with the company reassuring customers its operations remain business as usual. Meanwhile, Bloomberry Resorts dismisses as mere speculation a report that said it is eyeing to expand operations to Thailand. The operator of the Solaire Resort and Casino, and recently of Solaire North, told the local boards there is no such plan. It responded to query from an online report, which said Bloom is monitoring Thailand's efforts to legalize casinos for a boost in revenues.